Hello, I'm Romila. Welcome to English Grammar Series. Grammar, as we all know, is the foundation of language. If you don't understand grammar, you will not be able to speak well, you will not be able to write well. Isily, we are starting with this series to help you understand grammar, to help you build a solid foundation in grammar. So you will be able to speak more confidently, you will be able to write properly. Theek hai? So this is an introductory session. I'll be introducing you to some basic topics in grammar. So let's start. ये तीन concepts हैं, types of sentences, kinds of sentences, subject and predicate, phrase and clause. तो ये तीन concepts आज समझेंगे हम इस session में. So let's start with types of sentences. चार type के sentences होते हैं. First is declarative or assertive. Okay, declarative or assertive sentences. Any sentence which makes a statement, an assertion or a declaration. कुछ बोला जाता है, a statement is made, an assertion is made, something is declared. ऐसे sentences को हम declarative या assertive sentences बोलते हैं. Next is interrogative sentences. These are basically your questions. Any sentence which ends with a question mark is an interrogative sentence. ठीक है? Imperative. Imperative sentence is what? Any sentence which includes a command or entity. You're making a command, order दे रहे हो, request कर रहे हो, entity. An entity is a humble request. You're pleading someone कि please have mercy on us, please let me go. Okay? तो command, entity, request, order, ऐसे sentences को imperative sentences बोलते हैं. And then exclamatory sentence. Any sentence which expresses a strong, sudden feeling. Okay? जिस sentence में exclamation mark आता है, exclamation point आता है, वो exclamatory sentences होते हैं. Okay? So let's understand with a few examples here. Declarative and assertive sentence. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. कुछ statement, कुछ बोला गया है. You're making a statement, you're asserting something, you're declaring something. Okay? Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. बस कुछ बता रहे हो. You're not asking a question, you're not making a command, order नहीं दे रहे हो, request नहीं कोई, बस एक statement बोल रहे हो आप. Okay? Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. या He is an honest man. He is a good boy. Okay? तो ये हो गए हमारे declarative या assertive sentences. Next है interrogative. तो आ गए हमारे questions. Where do you live? Is this the way to the train station? Okay? Question mark आ गया. Interrogative sentence है. Imperative है. Order है, command है, request है, entreaty है. Be quiet. Sit quietly. Don't talk. Okay? Listen to me. Order है या command है. And have mercy upon us. Please let me go. Please leave me alone. Okay? ये entreaty है. You're requesting. You're making a humble request. You're pleading. Okay? तो ये हो गए हमारे imperative sentences. And finally, we have exclamatory sentences. What a beautiful day. Wow, what a beautiful day. How cold the night is. Okay? Exclamation mark है यहाँ पर. तो ये हमारे exclamatory sentences है. Okay? I hope this part is clear. Now, moving on to subject and predicate, a very basic but a very important concept in grammar. So, you have three sentences in front of you. The singing of the birds delights us. The earth revolves around the sun. The beautiful rainbow soon faded away. Her sentence ke do parts hote hain. Okay, we'll come back to these sentences. Every sentence is divided into two parts. Subject hota hai and predicate hota hai. But what is the subject? What is the predicate? Let's see. Subject is a name. Okay, a subject names something, names a person or a thing. It introduces us to something. Kisi cheez ka introduction deta hai, subject. And predicate jo hota hai, wo hume us subject ke baare mein kuch batata hai. The predicate says something about that person or thing. Okay, so the subject names something, it talks about something, it introduces us to something, and the predicate gives us some additional information about that thing. Okay? And let's come back to our examples. सबसे पहले है, the singing of the birds delights us. You can see I have divided the sentence into two parts. Okay? ये एक हो गया, ये दो, दूसरा हो गया. तो इसमें से एक subject है, एक predicate है. The singing of the birds. Now, यहाँ पे किसी चीज का introduction दिया गया है. Okay? The statement, the sentence is introducing us to something. The singing of the birds. तो ये हमारा subject हो गया. And then second part है, delights us. What does it do? Singing of the birds क्या करता है? It delights us. तो ये part हमारा predicate है. It is telling us something about the subject. Subject के बारे में बोल रहा है. Okay? The singing of the birds delights us. Okay? तो ये हो गया subject and predicate. Same with the second sentence. यह हो गया हमारा first part. ये हो गया second part. The earth again we are being introduced to something. The subject is naming something, the earth is the subject, and what does it do? It revolves around the sun. So ye hamara predicate hai. Same with the last sentence, the beautiful rainbow. Again, this part is naming something, okay, naming a thing or a person, the beautiful rainbow. And what does it do? What happened to the beautiful rainbow? It soon faded away. So the predicate is talking about the subject. So ye ho gaya hamara subject and predicate. I hope this is clear. Now, you can notice ki in tino sentences mein, subject pehle aaya hai, predicate baad mein aaya hai. Theek hai? But there's no such rule. Sometimes the subject may come after the predicate. Okay? Jaise in sentences mein dekho. Here comes the bus. Again, ye ho gaya hamare do parts. Isme se ek subject hai, ek predicate hai. Theek hai? Now, if you see the first part of all these three sentences, here comes, here is, sweet are, these don't make any sense, okay? So, ye hamare subject nahi hai. Here comes, is it introducing us to something? Is it naming something? Here comes, here is, sweet are. Yahan pe kisi bhi cheez ka introduction nahi diya gaya hai. To ye hamare subjects nahi hai. Second part dekho, the bus, your book, the uses of adversity. Yahan pe we are being introduced to something. Yahan pe this part is naming something, introducing us to something. To yahan pe ulta hai in teeno sentences mein. Predicate pehle aaya hai, subject baad mein aaya hai. The bus, here comes the bus. Okay, so the bus is the subject and here comes is the predicate. Okay, your book is here. Here is your book. So your book is the subject. Here is the predicate. The uses of adversity is the subject. Sweet are. Matlab the uses of adversity are sweet. Okay, so in sub cases, mein, predicate pehle aaya hai, subject baad mein aaya hai. Theek hai? Now, in imperative sentences, the subject is left out. Imperative sentence kya hai? Command hai, order hai, entreaty hai, request hai. Aise sentences mein, subject is left out. Subject aata hi nahi. Okay? So you can see some examples here. Orders hai, imperative sentences hai. Sit down, thank him, shut the door, listen to me. Yahan pe koi subject nahi hai. Kyunki subject is implied. Implied hai. Matlab understood hai. You can understand. Ki the subject is you, aapse baat kar rahi hu, jaise I'm teaching you. So if I ask you to listen to me carefully, pay attention, so it is understood that I'm talking to you, you are the subject. I don't need to say you listen to me or you pay attention because the subject, you, is implied, it is understood. Isiliye wo yahan pe nahi aayega, theek hai? To sit down ka matlab kya hai? You sit down, thank him, matlab you thank him. Shut the door, matlab you shut the door. Listen to me, you listen to me. So yahan pe you bolne ki koi zarurat nahi hai because it is understood, it is implied that you are the subject. Okay? So aise sentences mein, imperative sentences mein, the subject is left out. Okay? Now, we have 8 sentences here. Aapko kya karna hai? You have to identify the subject from the in these sentences. Subject kya hai, predicate kya hai, wo aapko find out karna hai. So pause this video and mark your answer, note your answer, and then we'll check. So I hope you've noted your answers. So sare sentences mein maine subject ko underline kiya hai. Okay, so let's see the first sentence. Stone walls do not make a prison. Do part ho gaye sentence ke. Stone walls. Kis cheez ki baat ho rahi hai? Stone walls. This part is naming something, introducing us to something. Stone walls. So ye hamara subject hai. Okay? And uske baare mein kya bola gaya hai? Stone walls do not make a prison. To ye part hamara predicate hai. Next, nature is the best physician. Yahan pe bhi nature ki baat ho rahi hai, to nature hamara subject hai. Is the best physician is the predicate. He has a good memory. Again, he. Kisi ladke ki, kisi insaan ki baat ho rahi hai. To ye hamara subject hai. Has a good memory. Predicate hai. The early bird catches the worm. The early bird is the subject. Okay. This part is naming something or someone. And catches the worm. What does the early bird do? It catches the worm. So that is the predicate. We should profit by experience. We. Subject hai. Should profit by experience, predicate hai. The dewdrops glitter in the sunshine. The dewdrops, subject hai. Glitter in the sunshine, predicate hai. What do the dewdrops do? They glitter in the sunshine. Now, See the last two sentences. A barking sound the shepherd hears. यहाँ पे first part देखो, a barking sound. Is it naming something? Is it introducing us to something? Is there a person here? No, तो वो subject नहीं है. The shepherd, ये हमारा subject है. Okay? The shepherd is the subject and a barking sound hears. ये हमारा predicate है. देखो, दो predicate के बीच में आ गया है subject. And see the last statement. On the top of the hill lives a hermit. यहाँ पे भी उल्टा हो गया है. Predicate पहले आया है and subject बाद में आया है. Who? A hermit. यहाँ पे a person is being named. We are being introduced to someone. Okay? A hermit. तो subject है. On top of the hill lives is the predicate. तो I hope subject predicate का concept is clear. Let's move on to phrase and clause. What is a phrase? What is a clause? So phrases and clauses are basically groups of words that act as a unit within a sentence. Let's understand. Phrases dekhte hai pehle. You have three sentences here. The sun rises in the east. Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. All of them went to the beach. Theek hai, teen sentences hai. So in sentences mein, in the first sentence, in the east is a phrase. On a wall is a phrase. To the beach is a phrase. लेकिन आप पूछोगे कि मैम identify कैसे करना है, कैसे पता चलेगा कि ये phrase है. How do you identify a phrase? What is a phrase? तो simple है. Phrase में subject और verb नहीं होता. Subject तो पता है, the part of a sentence which introduces us to something, which names something, that is a subject. वो तो that you understand. Okay? तो ये subject में देखो. फ्रेज में देखो कोई सब्जेक्ट नहीं है. ओके, इन द ईस्ट, ऑन अ वॉल, टू द बीच, देयर इज नो सब्जेक्ट. ओके, यू आर नॉट नेमिंग एनीथिंग, एनी पर्सन. ओके, देयर इज नो सब्जेक्ट, सब्जेक्ट इज मिसिंग. एंड वर्ब भी नहीं है. व्हाट इज अ वर्ब? अ वर्ब इज अ वर्ड दैट डिनोट्स एन एक्शन. टॉक, वॉक, ईट, स्लीप. ओके, ये वर्ब्स हैं. तो फ्रेजेस में वर्ब्स नहीं होते. नो सब्जेक्ट, नो वर्ब. ओके, क्लॉज. क्लॉज देखो, सेम थ्री सेंटेंसेस है, लेकिन यहाँ पे द सन राइजेस इज द क्लॉज. हम्प्टी डम्प्टी सैट इज द क्लॉज. ऑल ऑफ देम वेंट इज द क्लॉज. ठीक है, बाकी का जो पार्ट है वो हमारा फ्रेज है. ओके, इन द ईस्ट, ऑन अ वॉल, टू द बीच, विच वी सॉ अर्लियर. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे जो फर्स्ट पार्ट है तीनों सेंटेंसेस का, दैट इज आर क्लॉज. द सन राइजेस, हम्प्टी डम्प्टी सैट, ऑल ऑफ देम वेंट, तीनों क्लॉजेस हैं. What is the difference between subject, between phrase and clause? Phrase में subject नहीं होता, verb नहीं होता. Clause में दोनों होते हैं, subject भी है and verb भी है. There's a subject verb component. The sun, subject है. Humpty Dumpty, subject है. All of them, subject है. तो subject आ गया. Rises, verb है. Sat, verb है. Went, verb है, action है. Rises, sat, went, these are your verbs. तो clause में दोनों हैं. ओके, सब्जेक्ट भी है एंड वर्ब भी है. देयर इज अ सब्जेक्ट वर्ब कंपोनेंट. फ्रेज में देयर इज नो सब्जेक्ट वर्ब कंपोनेंट. ओके, वंस अगेन लेट समराइज. फ्रेज वर्सेस क्लॉज. इन द ईस्ट, ऑन अ वॉल, टू द बीच, दीज आर योर फ्रेजेस. फ्रेजेस डू नॉट कंटेन अ सब्जेक्ट वर्ब कंपोनेंट. नो एस प्लस वी. नो सब्जेक्ट, नो प्रेडिकेट, दोनों भी नहीं. सॉरी, नो सब्जेक्ट, नो वर्ब. ओके, नो एस प्लस वी. Clause, the sun rises, Humpty Dumpty sat, all of them went, contains a subject-verb component. Subject-verb component hota hai, S plus V. So, aa gaya samajh? Okay, phrase mein, no S plus V, no subject plus verb. Clause mein, S plus V, subject plus verb. Okay, subject-verb component. I hope this is clear. Okay, clauses dekhte hai. Clauses do type ke hote hai, independent clause and dependent clause. तो क्या है इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज, क्या है डिपेंडेंट क्लॉज? लेट्स टेक एन एग्जाम्पल. व्हेन आई गॉट होम, आई एट डिनर. दो क्लॉजेस हैं. व्हेन आई गॉट होम, आई एट डिनर. दोनों भी क्लॉजेस हैं. नाउ लेट्स सी कि इंडिपेंडेंट कौन सा है एंड डिपेंडेंट कौन सा है. व्हाट इज एन इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज? एन इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज कैन बी अ सेंटेंस. इट मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंस. जैसे when I got home, I ate dinner में, I ate dinner is our independent clause. Why? Because it can be a sentence on its own. अपने आप में ही एक sentence है. आई एट डिनर. अंडरस्टैंडेबल, समझ में आ गया. आई एट डिनर, इट मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंस. आई डोंट हैव टू से एनीथिंग फर्दर, उसके आगे कुछ बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है. इट्स कंप्लीट, इट मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंस. अपने आप में ही एक सेंटेंस है. इट कैन बी अ सेंटेंस, इट कैन स्टैंड ऑन इट्स ओन. इसलिए उसे बोलेंगे इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज. इंडिपेंडेंट है, उसे किसी और चीज की जरूरत नहीं है. बट सी द फर्स्ट पार्ट, ये वाला क्लॉज देखो. व्हेन आई गॉट होम, नाउ इफ आई से व्हेन आई गॉट होम, आप पूछोगे ओके आगे क्या, व्हाट नेक्स्ट. व्हेन आई गॉट होम डजंट मेक एनी सेंस, आगे कुछ तो होगा ना. तो व्हेन आई गॉट होम हमारा डिपेंडेंट क्लॉज है. इट कैन नॉट बी अ सेंटेंस. When I got home cannot be a complete sentence. Okay, उसे आगे it needs something. Okay, it depends on something. It is incomplete. Does not make complete sense. लेकिन if I say when I got home I ate dinner, then you understand कि okay अच्छा when you got home you ate dinner. Now it is understood. Now it makes complete sense. So the dependent clause depends on something to make complete sense. Okay, तो ये हो गया independent clause and dependent clause. I hope this is clear. So this is it for today's session. I hope you all understood the basic concepts. In the upcoming sessions, we'll get into the details. Detail mein samjhenge the more important concepts, the more important topics. So I hope you all enjoyed this session. Thank you for watching. I'll see you all in the next session.